Rottweilers are dogs that were originally bred to drive cattle to market. They were later used to pull carts for butchers. They were among the first police dogs to serve with honors in the military. Most importantly, they are popular family caregivers and friends. New pet parents should be careful as these dogs are strong and tough. They need experienced care and training. Steady, energetic pet parents will find a loving, loyal, and intelligent friend for life in the bred. Like the mythical Greek hero Hercules, the Rottweiler is strong and real with a loving heart. Popularly known as Rotties or Rots, this breed originated in Germany and was used to drive cattle and pull carts for farmers and butchers. That legacy is reflected in the bred's wide chest and tightly muscular body. As he moves, he shows strength and energy, but when you look into his eyes, you see warm, dark brown pools that reflect a gentle, intelligent, alert, and bold expression. A well-grown Rottweiler is calm and confident. He usually stays away from strangers but is never cowardly or fearful. Rottweilers show a wait-and-see attitude when dealing with new people and situations. When these traits are added as needed, the Rottweiler is a gentle, natural-bodied dog that thrives not only in police, military, and customs, but also as a family friend and protector. Bred has a natural instinct to protect their families and can be cruel to protect them. Prior socialization, providing permanent, fair, consistent training and regular employment to lead and execute is essential to directing their power and security. When this does not happen, Rottweilers can become even more dangerous bullies than the assistant caretakers they intend to be. Rottweilers draw a fine line between safety and aggression. If they are calm, intelligent, and properly socialized and trained, they can be overly secure. It may seem like what you want, but bred without the ability to discriminate is dangerous not only to bad people but to everyone he meets. You need to be able to give your Rottweiler reliable and respectable leadership without anger or physical coercion. Otherwise, he takes on the role of the top dog for himself. With a powerful and intelligent dog like Rottweiler, this is a recipe for disaster. Despite what you've heard, Rottweilers are not impulsive or inherently evil. Well-grown, well-socialized bred is playful, gentle, and loves their families. They are easy to train if treated with respect and make great friends. Rottweilers, no matter how cool they are, not everyone is a dog. Not only do you have to commit to training and socializing your bred, you have to deal with people who do not understand the breed and prejudge it. Due to bad or tragic experiences with Rottweilers or other large breeds, some cities have banned this breed. It would be unfair to judge a whole species by the actions of a few, but it is a reality that you will have to face if you are a Rottweiler. By training your Rottweiler to obey and respect people, you can do your part to redeem the breed's reputation. Most importantly, do not forget to keep your bred in the garden. This is a dog that is loyal to its people and wants to be with them. If you give him the guidance and structure he needs, you will receive a gift from one of the best companions in the world. History: Rottweilers are descended from the Mastiff breed of Molossus. Their ancestors went to Germany with the Romans, and when they conquered the world they knew, they drove the cattle they fed. As the army moved, large dogs mated with dogs endemic to the areas they passed through, laying the groundwork for a new breed. One area they traveled to was southern Germany, where the Romans established colonies to take advantage of the climate and soil suitable for agriculture. They built villas with red-tiled roofs. More than 600 years later, as they were building a new church, the inhabitants of the city excavated the site of the old Roman baths and discovered one of the red-tiled villas. This discovery gave the city a new name, Das Rottweil. Over the centuries, Rottweilers flourished as a market for cattle, similar to the Germans in a Texas cattle city, and the Roman Molossus brought cattle to the city to slaughter offspring of dogs. To sell their cattle and protect their money from thieves, they put their stuffed wallets around the Rottweiler's neck when the cows returned home. Local butchers also used dogs to pull carts loaded with meat. Eventually, rail transport replaced cattle drives. The Rottweiler nearly became extinct. At a dog show in Heilbronn, Germany, in 1882, only one nondescript Rottweiler was exhibited. That situation began to change in 1901, when the Rottweiler and Leonberger Club was founded and the first Rottweiler breed standard was written. The description of the Rottweiler's appearance and character has changed little since then. Rottweilers began to be used in police work, for which they were well suited. Several Rottweiler breed clubs were formed over the years, but the one with staying power was the Allgemeiner Deutscher Rottweiler Club, ADRK, founded in 1921. The ADRK survived World War II and has continued to promote good breeding programs in Germany and throughout the world. It's dedicated to preserving the working ability of the Rottweiler. It's thought that the first Rottweiler came to the US with a German emigrant in the late 1920s. The first litter was whelped in 1930, and the first dog registered by the American Kennel Club was Stina V. Felsenmeer in 1931. After World War II, the breed started becoming more popular. At that time, it was primarily known as an excellent obedience dog. The height of the Rottweiler's popularity was in the mid-1990s when more than 100,000 were registered with the American Kennel Club. Being popular isn't necessarily a good thing when you're a dog. It's not unusual for irresponsible breeders and puppy mills to try to cash in on the popularity of a breed and start producing puppies without regard for health and temperament problems. This is what happened to the Rottweiler breed until bad publicity and the demand for them decreased. Dedicated, reputable breeders are taking this chance to turn the breed around and ensure that Rottweilers are the type of dogs they were meant to be. Today, Rottweilers rank 17th among the 155 breeds and varieties registered by the AKC. Size males typically are 24 to 27 inches tall at the shoulder and weigh 95 to 130 pounds. Females typically are 22 to 25 inches tall at the shoulder and weigh 85 to 115 pounds. Care: it's important for Rottweilers to live in the home with their people. If they're left alone in a backyard all the time, they can become bored, destructive, and aggressive. Although they're large, Rottweilers are inactive indoors. A Rottweiler is a homebody, but he requires a fenced yard not only to protect him from traffic but also because he can be aggressive toward other dogs and strangers who come onto his property. An underground electronic fence can't keep your Rottie in your yard if he really wants to get out. More important, it doesn't prevent people or other animals from coming onto your property. Put up a sign advising strangers and non-family members not to come onto your property without your escort. The Rottweiler's energy level ranges from couch potato to whirlwind. Be sure to tell the breeder what kind of energy level suits you so she can help you choose the best puppy for your lifestyle. Moderately active Rottweilers will appreciate a couple of 10 to 20 minute walks each day. They also enjoy playing with balls and going hiking. More energetic Rotties may need longer exercise times and more structured activities. Their athleticism, intelligence, and trainability make them well suited to agility and obedience competition, as well as tracking, therapy work, and their traditional job, pulling a cart or wagon. Perfect for parades. When training your Rottweiler, keep in mind that he thrives on mental stimulation. He likes to learn new things and is eager to please you. He might be willful at times, with a, "show me why I should do this," attitude. Be fair, consistent, and firm, and your Rottweiler will reward you with his quick ability to learn. Your Rottweiler shouldn't be difficult to house train given a consistent schedule, no opportunities to have accidents in the house, and positive reinforcement when he potties outdoors. Personality: the ideal Rottweiler is calm, confident, and courageous, never shy. He has a self-assured aloofness and doesn't make friends with people immediately or indiscriminately. Instead, he takes a wait-and-see attitude with new people or situations. With his family, he's affectionate, often following them around the house. This is not a highly excitable dog. He has an inherent desire to protect his family and property, but should never be aggressive toward people without cause. The Rottweiler is smart and adaptable with a strong work ethic. You'll see some differences between the sexes. Males are quiet but watchful, constantly assessing their surroundings for threats. Females are somewhat easier to control and may be more affectionate. Both are highly trainable but can be stubborn. Rottweilers require firm, consistent but not harsh discipline. A sharp word is often a sufficient reprimand, but only if you've clearly established your leadership. If not, he may try to bully or bluff you. This is not a dog for people who lack assertiveness or don't have time to devote to training and supervision. Earning a Rottweiler's respect involves setting boundaries and teaching consequences for inappropriate behavior, both of which take time and patience. Temperament is affected by a number of factors, including heredity, training, and socialization. Puppies with nice temperaments are curious and playful, willing to approach people and be held by them. Choose the middle-of-the-road puppy, not the one who's beating up his littermates or the one who's hiding in the corner. Always meet at least one of the parents, usually the mother is the one who's available, to ensure that they have nice temperaments that you're comfortable with. Meeting siblings or other relatives of the parents is also helpful for evaluating what a puppy will be like when he grows up. Like every dog, Rotties need early socialization, exposure to many different people, sights, sounds, and experiences, when they're young. Socialization helps ensure that your Rottweiler puppy grows up to be a well-rounded dog. Enrolling him in a puppy kindergarten class is a great start. Inviting visitors over regularly, and taking him to busy parks, stores that allow dogs, and on leisurely strolls to meet neighbors will also help him polish his social skills. Health Rottweilers are generally healthy, but like all breeds, they're prone to certain health conditions. Not all Rotties will get any or all of these diseases, but it's important to be aware of them if you're considering this breed. If you're buying a puppy, find a good breeder who will show you health clearances for both your puppy's parents. Health clearances prove that a dog has been tested for and cleared of a particular condition. In Rotties, you should expect to see health clearances from the Orthopedic Foundation for Animals, OFA, for hip dysplasia, with a score of fair or better, elbow dysplasia, hypothyroidism, and von Willebrand's disease, from Auburn University for thrombopathia, and from the Canine Eye Registry Foundation, CERF, certifying that eyes are normal. You can confirm health clearances by checking the OFA website. Care. It's important for Rottweilers to live in the home with their people. If they're left alone in a backyard all the time, they can become bored, destructive, and aggressive. Although they're large, Rottweilers are inactive indoors. A Rottweiler is a homebody, but he requires a fenced yard not only to protect him from traffic but also because he can be aggressive toward other dogs and strangers who come onto his property. An underground electronic fence can't keep your Rottie in your yard if he really wants to get out. More important, it doesn't prevent people or other animals from coming onto your property. Put up a sign advising strangers and non-family members not to come onto your property without your escort. The Rottweiler's energy level ranges from couch potato to whirlwind. Be sure to tell the breeder what kind of energy level suits you so she can help you choose the best puppy for your lifestyle. Moderately active Rottweilers will appreciate a couple of 10 to 20 minute walks each day. They also enjoy playing with balls and going hiking. More energetic Rotties may need longer exercise times and more structured activities. Their athleticism, intelligence, and trainability make them well suited to agility and obedience competition, as well as tracking, therapy work, and their traditional job, pulling a cart or wagon. Perfect for parades. When training your Rottweiler, keep in mind that he thrives on mental stimulation. He likes to learn new things and is eager to please you. He might be willful at times, with a, show me why I should do this, attitude. Be fair, consistent, and firm, and your Rottweiler will reward you with his quick ability to learn. Your Rottweiler shouldn't be difficult to house-train given a consistent schedule, no opportunities to have accidents in the house, and positive reinforcement when he potties outdoors. Feeding recommended daily amount. 4 to 10 cups of high-quality dry food a day, divided into two meals. Note: how much your adult dog eats depends on his size, age, build, metabolism, and activity level. Dogs are individuals, just like people, and they don't all need the same amount of food. It almost goes without saying that a highly active dog will need more than a couch potato dog. The quality of dog food you buy also makes a difference. The better the dog food, the further it will go toward nourishing your dog and the less of it you'll need to shake into your dog's bowl. Keep your Rottweiler in good shape by measuring his food and feeding him twice a day rather than leaving food out all the time. If you're unsure whether he's overweight, give him the eye test and the hands-on test. First, look down at him. You should be able to see a waist. Then place your hands on his back, thumbs along the spine, with the fingers spread downward. You should be able to feel but not see his ribs without